Hey everybody, and welcome back to Vinyl Talk with Tavis. And I'm Tavis. I'm just laying here in my bed, and I've had time to think about it. But this morning, I woke up to some wonderful news and a wonderful video of Diana Ross singing happy birthday to Beyonce, her 42nd birthday on her Renaissance tour. And it was so heart-wrenching. It was so warming. And it meant a lot to Diana Ross fans and Beyonce fans as well. Because Diana Ross, if y'all don't know, I'm sure you all know, those who are watching, Diana Ross was the Beyonce of the day back in the 70s and 80s. Now, I am a living witness because I was right there. I fell in love with Diana Ross. She was my first celebrity crush. I fell in love with her when she was with the Supremes, and I listened to their records. And I really didn't have a handle on Diana Ross as a solo artist until I heard the Supremes record. And then I became aware of Diana Ross in that vein. And I was like, who is this woman singing? Who are these three girls singing this beautiful music? And I was just head over heels with Baby Love and Stop in the Name of Love and Someday We'll Be Together. And then I heard Reach Out and Touch. And then I heard Ain't No Mountain High Enough. I'm like, who is this woman? And I did my research. As a little boy, 11 years old, man, Diana Ross was like everything to me. I had the pictures of her all in my room when she did the Why Do Fools Fall in Love album. I had that album hanging up in my room with no apologies. My daddy would say all the time, why are you sitting all the way up to the TV on the floor? When he'd say Diana Ross was on TV, I would not sit on the couch. I would sit by the television, legs crossed, right by the screen. She meant so much to me. And to see her give Beyonce respect, and to see Beyonce give such respect back to Diana Ross, was just a magical moment. And I want to share with you what Beyonce said to Diana Ross, or to her audience in general, after it was all over. After giving a round of thank yous, Beyonce said, my soul is full. I'm so thankful. I'm trying not to cry. I'm thankful to be alive. I'm thankful to be on stage. I'm thankful to look out and see your faces. I'm thankful to be able to provide a safe space for all of y'all. I'm thankful for music, for the ability to heal myself through music, which then heals all of you. She then gave more thank yous and referenced her 2016 album, Lemonade, saying, I'm thankful we all have the ability to make lemonade out of our lemons. Amen to that. And she concluded by saying, I thank you that I'm here at fucking 42. I'm grateful for joy and I thank God. That's what I'm talking about. Just being thankful and showing thanks, giving thanks, giving reverence to those who came before you and who laid the foundation that you may have a right to the tree of liberty to do what you're doing today. Because you can only imagine what Diana Ross and the Supremes went through during the mid-60s. All of our black artists, what they had to go through to showcase what they had to give to the world. And we have Beyonce and Destiny's Child and all these great acts from the 90s and And now Beyonce is 42 years old. Child, where's the time gone? I just had to come on here and say that because it just meant so much to me. And as always, with music and with great artists like Beyonce and with legendary, iconic artists like Dinah Ross, be inspired and stay inspired.